a Keeper Bros video. Today we're going to be trying out a little bit of a newer game instead of Roblox today. We're going to be playing some Simple Planes. We're going to be checking out a few mods and one plane. We're going to be reviewing them, seeing how good they are, and doing a few like fun little experiment type things. So let's jump into it. Alright guys, here's the plane we'll be using. It is the F-18 Hornet. It's a pretty cool plane. It's very well modeled after the real plane. It has a few added features, obviously. You can see it has a bunch of countermeasures up here and on the sides here. You can also see that there are a few parachute deployment, which I think is like probably my favorite thing about this plane. So those are pretty much the main features. It does not come with any guns or missiles or any weapons of that type on the plane, but as you know, you can easily add them through your weapons tab. So that's probably the only down thing about this plane, but other than that, this plane is very well made. Another feature that I usually don't see on planes like this are these little tail fins here. You'll see when we test it out in just a sec that it has very, very good maneuverability, and I think that comes from these little fins here and the little fins here. So yeah, overall this is a very maneuverable, fast plane. I really like it. It's probably my new favorite plane. I would recommend it to a lot of my friends who play Simple Planes, because it's really fast, and it can hold a bunch of weapons. So you can like put them here, on the wings, and then sometimes you can even have like a torpedo, or a few missiles right here. Those are usually good because you can get right low. So let's test this baby out. Alright guys, here we are. So this is what the plane looks like from the outside. I mean, looks great. I think they could have done maybe a little bit better job with the paint, but I mean, it was in beta, they said, so in the description, so I mean, it's not going to be like perfect. They said they were going to maybe update the engine intake, which you can see right there, those little black openings. Those on either side, those give like oxygen or whatever to these engines back here. And they said they were probably going to update the color. So yeah, that was just something I wanted to say, because that was one thing I saw, and I didn't know if I was going to like it, because the color just was off, and I usually just don't have a good time coloring these things. So yeah, but let's take off here. Let's see how well this is getting into chase. Alrighty, here we go. So let's see how well this thing takes off. Let's see, about 3/4 of the way down the runway when we had liftoff. Oh no, not even, probably about a little bit before half. So here, I mean, you can do flips. Let's pull in all landing gear. So I mean, it's pretty stable, just like it is here. You can see shaking a little bit after like you do an adjustment or whatever. Yeah, other than that, it's pretty stable, just going straight. It looks like diving and pulling up is pretty good, and try sideways, sideways. Yeah, those are pretty good. I like that. I feel like it does have very good maneuverability. Like, you can see those top fins. It doesn't really have, like, pitch, but, I mean, you can kind of see it attempts to do it. But when you're turning, that little extra top bit adds a bunch extra turn radius to the plane. So that's good. Overall, the maneuverability of this plane is very good. And another thing, just not like flying in air, but landing is very good also. So you know how we said we had those parachutes there? So those parachutes, when I think it's group one, when you activate them, what it does is it shoots them off of the top here in the front and the wings, and what I think that does is allows you to like land about upright. I mean, I think that's what they said in the description, that it does a little bit of slow descent and it does a little bit of flip. They said it can land of up to 100 miles an hour, so that sometimes leads to damage of your landing gear. But they said you can adjust the parachutes if it doesn't work out. But yeah, let's test it. So they said to put engines a little bit lower when coming in. They said put zero in, I think it's group, yep, it's group one. Then we'll extend on the engine. Yeah, so it does a pretty little flip there. I think the parachutes need to be adjusted just a little bit. As you can see, we're a little bit tilted, but I think it will even out. Let's see. Oh, that was actually really good. Wow. And yeah, so we didn't even have to like line up on the runway. We just kind of flew over and landed right here. But another thing is, if you're in like an air battle or something like that, and you need to deploy them quickly, all you do is boot two, and it just shoots them off. So I mean, that one's kind of floating on top there. But that's one of the also cooler features. If you want to do stunts, you can do them from the little passage up there. And you just deploy them in the air. You like do a little flip, and if you shoot up your throttle and you keep that on, I think you can like fly with them open and then like stop and land. So that, I mean, that's another cool little feature. Whoa, that's interesting. Wasn't expecting that to fly by. Wow. Okay. Well then. Yeah. So the only thing is, you can only use them once. But I mean, if you're landing on like an aircraft carrier, like the USS Beast. I don't know if I can slow down here. So there's a USS Tiny, you can see on the right there. That's the one that's having the little bay over there. And if we go like this, the USS Beast is there. Oh gosh. I think we just did a little jump there. But yeah, there's a little bay out to the right here, and then the ocean out to the left in the back kind of there. That middle one has two destroyers on the side, but that middle one is the main aircraft carrier, and you can land on that too. But it is not a spawn point. Jeez. Oh, smoke. Wait, let's see if this thing still flies, because that's another feature. Sometimes, when you are doing things like air battle and they hit your engine, things like what is going on is happening. Oh, yeah, I want to see this. Yeah, it is not doing too well. You can see that we are clearly flipping. If you could, you just saw right there. Here, we'll reset it quick, just to restart. So, you saw right there is when I was in cockpit view. We'll get into it right here. You can see that the parachute deployment, I mean, look to the side. So, on the side, it's fine. And behind us, I mean, it's just, yeah, it's just that. But you can see that parachute deployment is in the way. So, I mean, that does kind of cause you to not be able to see where you're locking on or shooting, because your crosshair is like right there. So that's kind of the downside about flying this in like first person. But other than that, the cockpit view is good. I mean, there's nothing on the sides. I mean, down is not clear usually, and same with the back. Yeah, so you can see here, if we do that, it just shoots it and does that, and just falls to the ground. And then if we need to deploy it, you'll see just the top piece right here just disappear. So if we go pew, and the parachute's like right there. So yeah, that's kind of one of the cool things about seeing that in first person. So yeah, another cool thing. But yeah, so I mean, once you get rid of it, it's not in the way. But yeah, so that's pretty much the F-18 Hornet. I think we have a nuke mod. It adds a huge explosion to this game, an advanced targeting mod, and a time warp mod, so we can like speed up time. So I think those will be good things to check out next. So let's get started on those. Alright guys, I just put the nukes on. So they look like the Boom 50s, except they're a little larger. Pull up a picture, and they're white. So if we pull up the Boom 50 here, this is the Boom 50. The Boom 50 is a 500 pound bomb, and obviously weighs 500 pounds. The nuke right here weighs 551 pounds, so it's a little bit heavier. But like when you have like a jet like this, it doesn't usually have an effect on it, unless you only put like one on one wing and like nothing on the other. It kind of tends to tilt the plane. But yeah, so this is what they look like. They're just simple, compact bombs. They're not ginormous or anything, and they don't weigh a ton, which I like, because I've looked at things like cleavers that were like downsized, but they weighed a ton. I don't know why they did that, but yeah. So, I mean, things that are like smaller but like have huge, larger explosions and like create huge smoke clouds usually tend to weigh more. So, yeah. We can jump in here. This will also test out the advanced targeting mod, which kind of helps you drop the bombs. So, let's get going on that. Alrighty guys, we're on the runway here, so we're gonna start a takeoff like normal. I have not tested these before yet. It did create a huge smoke cloud, in that it can sometimes lag out your game. But other than that, it shouldn't weigh down my plane. Yep, it's good. So, it said what to do with the advanced targeting is you're gonna go to air-air, and it doesn't do anything for that. But if we go to air-to-ground, oh, there it is. Wow, that's actually pretty cool. So, with that little circle there is, I'm guessing, is where I'm gonna drop the bomb, and I'm guessing the green part is the trajectory, if I'm not mistaken. So, what I think, yeah, so what that does is it's just gonna show me where the bomb's gonna land. So, if we come straight here and I fly up a little bit, we can try bombing our airport here. Alright, so bombs away. So we're gonna shoot out and pull off to the side and take that. So it should hit right about in the middle, close to that, of the airport. So let's watch. Can't see it. Oh, there it goes. Whoa. Oh my gosh, that was a really good mushroom cloud. Oh, hello. There it goes. Yeah, so you can see it like froze the game there, but because it has like a huge smoke cloud. But yeah, that's pretty much the nuke. I don't think it explodes in water, so that's kind of only problem I have with it, and that there's so much smoke. I feel like they could just maybe cut down on the smoke a little bit, and it wouldn't lag out your game so much. But yeah, so only problem I have with the water though also is if you're going for like the aircraft carrier, if I go to air ground, and actually go to, yeah, you target that, yeah. So, if you're going to bomb the aircraft carrier, the only problem I have with this mod is if you hit the water, like, watch, I'll just drop one now, I should have three, yeah. So, there's not going to be an explosion, we can just let that one be, it'll just prove that there isn't one. So, what's going to happen is there's just, no matter what, going to be an explosion. We'll just hit the water and sink. But, whoa, I think that's a little, you guys see that red thing there? I think that's a little crosshair telling me where I should hit. So I just thought, I think we were on it. But yeah, there was a little red thing like on the back of that there. I guess that's what it's saying to aim for. That's another cool thing. I think that's, I've never actually seen that. I only tested this out once with the Boom 50. We'll see if we hit. If it does no explosion, then obviously we don't hit. But that's the, yeah, that's the problem, is it's very hard to hit targets like that in the water. I mean, anyway, I don't know why you'd want a nuclear bomb fleet. Yeah, I don't think we hit it. I don't know why you'd want a nuclear bomb fleet, because, I mean, there's really no point. It's a lot easier to take it out with, like, some other high explosive, like, really high explosive. It makes sense, but I just don't get why they wouldn't just add that it would explode, like, next to it. I mean, if you think about it, water's pretty hard if you hit it fast, and I feel like the bomb should explode, but that's okay. I mean, other than that, the mod's amazing, except for the fact that it lags. But yeah, so I really like that mod. It's also good for if you're doing, I think it's the convoy campaign, or whatever you call thing there, where you have to stop the convoy before it gets to the base. Try that out, maybe another video. Comment down below if you think that would be a good thing to try. We could try using this jet with different weapons. We could try rocket pods. I do have a Russian mod pack which has a big rocket pod. Comment down below if you want that. I think that would look good. But yeah, so those are those two mods. Now the next mod's gonna be pretty quick. I don't know how it's gonna go. I haven't tried it out. All I heard about it was that it can just kill your game, like, physics won't work. So what this is the time warp mod. So I believe it's K, yeah. So as you can see, it speeds it up, and if it was J, yeah, it goes back. So what this does is it enables you to get from place to place a lot faster. And you can see it's a lot harder to control your plane, so usually you just want it when you're on, like, a straightaway. so that you don't have to make adjustments. So if we do like, alright, so far we'll go, so six. Oh gosh, I want to set it back to one. Alright, yeah, so as you can see, that six, it wasn't doing too well. Alright, so if we go like, yeah, and all the enemy okay have to make damage, so. Seven. It's like lagging a little bit. Oh god, yeah. So right here, you can see, we're just gonna cut the ends, that I don't have any more wings. Oh, wow. Can I deploy? Airbrakes, maybe? Some of my flares work. Yeah, by the way, this plane has like 99 plus flares, so. Wow, well, that was interesting. My. Whoa, I didn't even have like wings. My wings were like, I don't want to be a thing today. I'm done. It's kind of left. So, wow. Okay, then. So, yeah, so that's the. Whoa. What the. Why are we going up? Oh, you did that by accident. Okay, then. I think we're gonna shoot up. I guess this is really buoyant or something. There it goes. So yeah, those are the few mods we checked out today. If you guys have any ideas for future videos, if you want to see new games, if you want your plane or vehicle or mod to be featured, just give us the link in the comments. We do read all the comments, so we will check that out. If you guys have any ideas for maybe a new like challenge we can do, I love to see those. I like to take your ideas for things like that. You guys usually have really good ideas. So yeah. So that's gonna be the end of the video for today. Like and subscribe if you haven't already. Join the Keeper Bros notification squad by hitting that subscribe button and clicking that notification bell. And I'll see you in the next video.